The server room that held all the information. Destroyed. If only it had been that easy. Dust was caked to every surface. It was hard to see anything. There were no obvious paths to take me to where Michael had been found. What was Michael even doing in there? He should have come home from work. Put Molly to sleep and we should have been eating a curry on the sofa with a glass of wine, for God's sake. I couldn't understand it at the time. How had it come to this? Talking about the future. That seems so stupid now, doesn't it? There's no way I could have known. This would hopefully help me find my way a little better. Some of the security was still engaged. They were trapped. All lives lost. James, he was around for dinner with Amy just 2 days before all this happened. Andrew, what's in the basement? He'd cry out for help as Michael would pretend to be a tiger stalking them in the lobby. Entire floors torn into one another. Michael was found in. Did I cause this?
Magnetic data found.
Lives ruined. Torn. They woke up that morning, went to work, and never returned. Michael's towel's still sat on the floor where he left it. I can't bear to pick it up. He should be the one doing it. I always told him to clean up after himself. Bears were blown out. I pushed and clawed my way through. I had to see it. I had to see where. Nail it tore my jumper. Can you believe it? My husband was found in the room next door, and for a split second I actually paused to care about a torn jumper. Trapped. No exit. And they said all the metal was burning hot. He suffered. It's the not knowing, isn't it? That's what really haunts you. The silhouette server. Somehow it survived the blast. The irony of it wasn't lost on me. The disc was lodged in the pneumatic system. I thought about Michael in his last moments, struggling to get to it. He knew that was the key to prevent the overheating. He had no hope of reaching the fuse box. Pulling the cartridge out took me back to that night. The deep thud. The loss of power. Loss of hope. Twice was almost too much to bear.
Apparently, security is tight in the Meta Center, so your second meeting might be a little harder. Try and give yourself another hour to prepare if you have the time. Alex Dubois worked for Chance Crow, so find out what he knows. Don't let me down.
Charles Bowman had some role in this. I don't know. I don't even know. Look. I don't want to believe that this could be true, but please, just go and speak to him and find out what you can. I don't know how to say goodbye. Just give the kids my love, and I'll pray I'll be with you soon. I love you.
Harvey, as you know, we've had lots of people calling up Gale and claiming they have information on who caused the explosion at the Bowman Carson building. We had one just a few minutes ago, which seems to hold some weight. A family member of one of the workers killed in the explosion mentioned that they were at a tour this morning where you are right now. Have you seen any evidence of this? If you can find any evidence at all of a cover-up, please keep it with you. Again, it seems very conspiracy theory, but you never know. Chat soon.
Bloody benefits in a bloody mine. There's hard work, and that's your lot. If these tops took 10% less money than they do now, then we'd be able to solve the whole bloody place, mate. You never hear about immigrant crisis they're all laughing on about.
You couldn't leave the house at night. And you know what? If you don't want the French here, then put down your bloody big hats. You know what I mean? Quiche. That's another one. All the nice cheeses. half the words we use every day. All them artists,
what you see on TV. If you're going to get rid of the people, then you can stop being hypocrites and all.
I don't mean to preach, but it just really puts me in a sour mood. You know. I'll catch you later.
No floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
Hello again. How are you?
Yeah, no worries. I'm recording the session as you asked.
And what, you just want me to mail it over to you? Okay, great. Hey, it's me! Oh, okay. Sure. Hey, it's me. Listen, I... Sure, was that not good? Yeah. I was trying to channel a little Shatner through it. Sure thing. Can I go down the script a little, just for getting out of the loop? Look, do you know how they view you? Okay, so, working on my British accent, so I don't have to put any more lies on my resume. Here goes. Cockney. We've got to hide the body under the apples and pears, Governor.
Consider this your final warning. Do this, do that. That's pretty good. Okay, Irish. You shut your face now. Summerfield, sounds of the 60s, 70s, and today, playing all the songs you've been listening to for the past 20 years, and you're still bored of. Next up, we have this little wee beauty by Buzzkill.
Thank you.
How do I compare thee? How do I compare thee?
What's that, Skippy? There's a boy stuck in the mines?
How do I compare thee?
Chance. Get out.
Hey, security can handle this.
Anyone else here, so you must be talking to me.
Damn it, Jim. I'm a duck.
Nothing, but I'm just gonna check something out.
You can't be here, sir.
Come on, you need to get out of this area now.
I'm sorry, sir, but I have to take you out of here. I'm still gonna catch you. I'm sorry, sir, but we're done. You have to leave this area. Come with me. Running away is not gonna help.
So,
do you mind if I smoke?
Go ahead. So, let's start at the beginning, shall we? What can you tell me about Alex Dubois?
What would you like to know?
Well, perhaps we should start with how he was able to gain access to a restricted part of your facility and detonate a device killing several people. I know you're used to being on the other side of the table. I get it. The quicker you give me what I need, the quicker...
Look, Mr. Dubois was difficult. Well, you've read the papers, you know the stories. I'm not sure you're going to get anything useful from me.
But you knew him. You spoke with him beforehand.
As an employee, yes.
I'm going to need your clothes, your keys.
What are you doing? I'm sorry, Mr. Miller, we can't keep doing this. You have to leave this area with me. Come on.
That's it. We're going to the security desk. Dan can handle this.
Mr. Miller, you're fast becoming a thorn in my side. I cannot stress this enough. Out-of-bounds areas are forbidden to the public. You must not enter these areas. With everything happening in the facility today, I don't have the time to deal with a disruptive journalist. You're on a final warning, Mr. Miller. If this happens again, you will be removed from the premises. Go to your meetings, take your notes, and finish your report. That is it, okay? Your next meeting is in the Meta Center with Chance Crow, and he isn't a person you want to get on the wrong side of.
No floppy disks detected.
I gotta get back to work. I got things to do. I don't have time for this. I gotta get back to work. Thank you.
Floppy disks detected.
Sir, you can't be here. Leave the area. Sir, you can't be here. Leave the area.
Sir, can you leave the area? Running away won't help.
Get back to work. Please enter PIN. Code accepted. Access granted.
What is it this time? Not sure if it's anything yet, but I'm just checking something out. Hey, Dan, I can't find him. I'll go back to what I was doing. If I see him again, I'll let him know.
No, no, fine. I gotta get back to work.
No floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
I got code to build. I don't have time for this. I gotta get back to work. I don't have time for this. I gotta get back to work. I don't have time for this. I got things to do.
No floppy disks detected.
Please insert token.
Hey, Mr. Miller, something fishy happened in one of the out-of-bounds areas earlier on. I know you probably had nothing to do with it, but for your safety, please make sure you stay in your allocated areas only, okay?
I'm a wee bit busy,
hi.
I'm afraid.
Denied. Access denied. Access denied.
Hey, Mr. Miller, I know you probably don't know anything about this, but something happened in one of the out-of-bounds areas earlier on. So if you could just stay in the allocated areas, just for your safety, that would be great. Thanks.
No floppy disks detected. No floppy disks detected.
Time for this. I got things to do.
No floppy disk detected. No floppy disk detected.
Door closing. Please enter PIN. I don't have time for this. I got things to do.
Please enter PIN.
I don't have time for this. I gotta get back to work.
Code denied. Please enter PIN. Code denied.
I got code.
What the hell is it now? Hey, Mr. Miller, I know you probably don't know anything about this, but something happened in one of the out-of-bounds areas earlier on. So if you could just stay in the allocated areas, just for your safety, that would be great. Thanks.
I got code to build. Ugh. I don't have time for this. I got things to do.
Please insert token. Please insert token.
I don't have time for this. I gotta get back to work.
Can't be here, sir.
Door's closing.
Whatever, man.
Door's opening. Door's closing.
Okay, so, working on my British accent, so I don't have to put any more lies on my resume. Here goes. Yeah, no worries. I'm recording the session as you asked. I'm here. Sorry. Steve.
Can I just get up with this, shall we?
Sure. Which part of the script would you like me to read from?
Yes. It's kind of thin there. How are your improvisation?
Okay, I guess.
That's encouraging, isn't it? Okay, I'm a debt collector, and you're behind the new payments. Go.
Okay. How much do I owe you?
It's
just so I know if I should, like, ask for...
Do
you mind if I smoke?
Go ahead. So, let's start at the beginning, shall we? What can you tell me about Alex Dubois?
What would you like to know?
Well, Perhaps we should start with how he was able to gain access to a restricted part of your facility and detonate a device killing several people. I know you're used to being on the other side of the table. I get it. The quicker you give me what I need, the quicker...
Look, Mr. Dubois was difficult. Well, you've read the papers, you know the stories. I'm not sure you're going to get anything useful from me.
But you knew him. You spoke with him beforehand.
As an employee, yes.
Indulge me, Mr. Bowman. Pretend I know nothing.
Please, call me Charles.
Well, we have it on record that you spoke with Mr. Dubois 1 week before the incident. However, when we looked, we couldn't find the interview session with him.
Well, it should be there. We log all activities without question. Perhaps you should speak to Sarah Smith and accounts about it.
Well, we did. She told us the same.
Well, there you have it.
You have no idea where it could have gone?
This is as worrying to me as it is to you, I'm sure.
You still haven't answered my question. How did Mr. Dubois get into a restricted area?
The police report said that he probably stole another worker's keycard.
Whose?
I have no idea, I'm afraid. He was a member of our tech department, and he was a very skilled employee, so...
Don't you find that a little convenient?
What's that supposed to mean? What exactly is it that you think I have to do with this detective?
Look, you detained and then extradited an employee's family, and then denied him the right to see them. What exactly did you think was going to happen? Perhaps not this, but you had to expect something, surely. Did Mrs. Carson see it coming? Is that why you fired her?
You're still with me. I'm playing the best of the best of all the classical singers.
Hello, Mr. Miller.
Mr. Miller,
I don't know
Miss
why
Berman
you
has made me aware that you're late for your meeting.
I've been told I have
Could you
to
please be on your way?
I do hope you have something interesting to ask. This is Miss Allison Whitworth. I'll be translating for you if you have any questions for her. Should we just get on with it? About the explosion? Well, pretty much what everyone else knows about it. I don't really know what you want me to say. You must know everything that I do. I was having a smoke in the courtyard. Luckily, I wasn't close enough to the blast, but I saw the whole thing. Probably in her office. Room 105. Anything else, Mr. Miller? Well, nothing. We weren't allowed back into the premises for over a week. Even then, only a handful of us were here to make sure things carried on running. The police were still here, and a detective was snooping around. I couldn't do anything without someone watching over me, or telling me to log what I was doing. Whatever they found, they didn't share it with me. I read it in the paper like everyone else. Some kind of bomb, I guess. On the gas lines. At least that's what the news said. We have a report of the official findings downstairs somewhere. Don't you believe me? Yeah, basically the gas line. She says he wrote some kind of code that overheated the servers, she thinks. He was a talented coder, much as I hate to admit it. He found out that the servers were close to a gas line that came from an external propane store and, well, you know the rest. Well, anything's possible, I guess. He was a better coder than me. I've been looking into it myself since it happened, purely out of curiosity. All he had to do was get it to overheat. It's actually not that hard, so yeah, I think he could have done it. I don't know. I'd have to replicate it to know. And obviously, that's not something anyone's interested in trying. I think you'd agree. Well, I'm not here to argue with the official findings. If you knew Alex at all, I'm sure you'd feel differently. If you don't have anything else to ask Ellie, should we move on? I'm not sure if that's a question or... Well, people are scared of things they don't understand, that's all. I think the key thing to take from this is that if you want to make the country better, then you can't be frightened to offend a few minorities. That's the best way I can put it. What doesn't offend them? The most common thing I hear is that people are going to be kicked out of the country. Now, I can't help that from happening, so I try to avoid letting it affect my work. But I hear it over and over, like no one wants to admit the border control problem. Let me put it like this. You leave your window open in your house one summer's day and a whole bunch of flies come in. You try to remove them, but the flies are coming in faster than you can get them out. Do you want to keep trying to catch the flies, Mr. Miller? Or do you perhaps want to think about shutting the window? I shouldn't have expected you to understand, Mr. Miller.
Excuse me, Mr. Crow. I need to have a word with you.
Can it wait, Dan? I'm in the middle of something here.
I'm aware of that. That's what I want to talk to you about.
Right.
Why are you here?
Right. It's come to my attention that you may have been collecting sensitive information in that briefcase of yours. I'm going to need you to hand them over, please. I'm going to pass them along to Charles Bowman, and when or if you have your meeting, he can decide what he wants to do with them.
Steve, please take Mr. Miller's belongings over to Mr. Bowman's office.
Sorry about this.
Oh, and we'll also need that dossier of yours. Right. Well, Mr. Miller, it seems as though this meeting is over. I'll look forward to hearing what Charles Bowman has to say about what you've been up to. Get him out of my sight.
Right, Mr. Miller. Let's go.
Keep it down, Charles. You wake the children.
I don't see what you're going to achieve by keeping your share. Why not just sign it over to me? We both want the same thing here.
We don't want the same thing, though, do we? You don't mind if hundreds of people lose their home in the process?
Yes, but...
No, there's no grey here. There's a very clear answer.
I don't believe that.
Charles, voice.
I don't believe that. What are you going to do when there are protests calling for this company's dismantling? What will you do then? Oh, maybe you always wanted this to fail. You're risking jeopardizing all of Michael's work. You always resented him for working such long hours. If he wasn't trying to get the changes you wanted in, then he'd probably still be here. Look.
Get out.